We will not leave town until we have fulfilled our obligation to cut spending.
Good thing to have a paid for house. As a matter of fact, it is a great thing to have a paid for house.
All right, so let's get into it. Part two of debunking and dispelling money myths as a veteran entrepreneur. You voted for it, so here's part two of dispelling money myths I've done in my life as a veteran entrepreneur. Another big week of the YouTube Best Comments Challenge on our YouTube channel. Thank you for your feedback and your comments. Here's who got the book Living a Life of Significance by George Jordan, and also a special invitation to a meetup with my mentor, Patrick Bet-David, when he arrives here in town during the InsuranceNewsNet Super Conference, September 26th through 28th, right here in Chicago. Not only is he delivering a keynote speech on one of the biggest stages inside the insurance industry, but he's also meeting with three individuals in a special meetup, and they are Arturo Marin, Abner Castaneda, Ellis Suazo. So listen, I'm loving your feedback, so we're going to extend the YouTube Best Comments Challenge for one last week and one last time. Once you finish watching this episode and you drop your best comments with your feedback and subscribe to our YouTube channel and also our Instagram profile and also our Facebook page, we'll be pulling the final winners on September 24th at 10 p.m. Central Standard Time. Meanwhile, if you haven't done so already and you're watching this on YouTube, make sure you click subscribe to our YouTube channel right here. Or if you're watching this on Facebook, make sure you click like and follow our business page. All right, so let's get into it. Part two of debunking and dispelling money myths as a veteran entrepreneur. You see, growing up being Filipino, it's in our culture to not only respect our elders, but also to speak only when spoken to. Being a United States Marine, it's in our DNA to listen to orders, follow orders, and follow through with those orders. Very little questions asked. You see, it's with this program during my early adult life that actually saved me from seeing opportunities and kept me from doing something special financially. In fact, I almost felt guilty wanting to be financially successful and financially rewarding myself. Even though silently, I wanted a better financial life. I mean, how many of you have kids, cousins, little nieces and nephews? You remember that childlike enthusiasm they have when expressed when you ask them, what do you want to be when you grow up? Astronaut, football player, president of the United States. And then what happens when they get to grade school, when they get to junior high? You see, life ends up hitting them in the mouth. And what happens to that dream machine? That dream machine shuts down. Sadly for most people, they never get a second, third, or fourth chance to ever express themselves financially. Rarely do they ever get a chance to actually sit down with somebody and talk about what it's like to evolve into the next best version of themselves. Worse, we find ourselves in relationships, and the majority of our arguments are about money, how we deal with money, and who should be getting it. Usually in most relationships, one of the biggest arguments that most people have, boyfriend, girlfriend, husband, wife, parents, is usually about finances. Biggest reasons why we believe in certain money myths and why money myths exist is because we regularly do not talk to somebody about dispelling these money myths.
Brought up, so if you want to dispel money myths, here's one of the things that you have to consider is number one, who are you talking to? So in terms of financial money myths that you want to dispel, who are you talking to? Babe, what do we say the first people we talk to? Number one, PBD. Number two, Vargas's. Number three, got time.
And in case you don't have anybody in your corner helping you dispel money myths, I'm glad that you're using this video to start the conversation between me and you. All right, money myth part two, let's prove him wrong. Older relatives don't always know what's best for you. Lola, I'm fired up, I'm excited. I decided to get out of the Marine Corps and become an entrepreneur because I want to make some money.
Entrepreneur? Hindi ko alam yan. What is that? No, get a job. You got bills to pay. Okay, Nat?
But Lola, I need to make money now. I don't have 2, 3, 4 years to wait to go to school.
No. When you get out of the Marine Corps, you go to the school, you get your education, you get a job like everybody else. What are you telling me, Anak? As if you're somebody.
But.
He needs some milk.
Oftentimes, older relatives have certain financial pain, frustrations, doubts, and fears that they actually subconsciously take out on you. Now, this is mostly done out of expression of love because they want to help you avoid a lot of the mistakes that they've made. As a parent and family man myself, I realize the power of words and how the subconscious beliefs in us come out in helping those that we love and care about. It wasn't until I decided to be a student of business and study why the rich were getting richer and had the steps to do something about it. Now, did I fall short and fail many times? Of course. But at the same time, did I believe that I was onto something and I tasted the flavor of a better life? 100%. Psst. It wasn't me doing business and depending on money from friends, family, and other relatives. I've made more money with strangers than I ever have with friends and family. All right, here's the next one. Don't need to cut spending to get ahead. Aren't you sick and tired of the traditional outdated advice about personal finances and how to get ahead?
A car payment is a way to ensure that you stay broke.
If you get your hair cut every 4 weeks, get it cut every 6.
We're getting rid of credit cards, pay them all off and close them up and cut them up.
If you go out to eat once a week, go out to eat every 2 weeks.
Now here's the real reality of America. Let's go back 25 years. This is what things used to cost. See, the cost of goods and services and having a living and making a living has actually gotten more expensive over time. Because bottom line, what has not gone up over the last 20, 25 years is income. People are working harder, but they're not getting paid anymore. Let's look at this chart about how much income and wages has gone up from a job. It's barely keeping up with purchasing power. Your money, your dollar, is buying less today. Focus on making money, not just simply cutting costs. There's a saying that goes, don't shrink your dreams to fit reality, but to upgrade your conviction, upgrade your knowledge to fit your destiny. Here's another money myth. Your house is the best investment. I know you've heard from a lot of friends and family, as soon as you start making money, buy real estate, buy your home. That's the greatest investment you'll ever make. Now, I know it's been a minute, but do you remember what happened about 10 years ago? During the Great Recession of 2008, 2009, the housing market crashed. Now, some of you who are probably under 23, 24 years old may have no clue what I'm talking about. You haven't seen a drop in the market as great as the Great Recession did. You see, I don't ever judge a friendship, a business relationship, or in this matter, an investment in the best of times. I want to see how things perform in the worst of times. And boy, did the housing market during the Great Recession 2008 prove what a money myth this was.
Okay, the consumer's strangled. They're watching their housing prices go lower. They're watching their 401ks get diminished.
Brought down by bad mortgage investments, Lehman, which has 25,000 employees, will be liquidated.
Now, although I do believe in home ownership, I just don't think it's the greatest investment out there. So let's check back in with a licensed life insurance agent on what the best home for money is. Babe, take it away.
Thanks, babe. Actually, Ruddy Ortiz here, Senior Marketing Director and a co-owner of PHP. Sheena last week went over with you the laser T-test, the 4 different criteria that we look at to be able to house your serious money in, right? So let's go over the 4 different types of homes that you can park your serious money in. So first of all, you have the banks, right? Well, with banks, your money's liquid. It's safe, FDIC insured up to $250,000. However, the rate of return lately has not been great. There's no tax break. It's got 2 out of the 4. Let's look at the stock market. Now, specifically when I'm talking about stock market, I'm talking about 401ks, IRAs, pensions, 403bs, right? Well, money's not liquid. You got to jump through some hoops, penalties, and fees to be able to access your money. It's not safe. We obviously know that because in 2007, 2008, most people lost. You can potentially get a good, decent rate of return. So it does give us that. And when it comes to tax advantages, we're going to give it a half of a check mark because you get tax breaks going in, but you get whacked in taxes when you're pulling out the money. If you look at it, you got 1.5 out of 4. Let's look at real estate. Real estate, as far as equity is concerned, it's not liquid. Is it safe? We also know in 2008 that most people lost money. Rate of return, Again, it all depends on outside factors, right? We gave it a half a point. You do get some tax breaks for owning real estate, and if you have a mortgage, you get to write off the interest and things like that. So when you add it all up, you're at 1.5 out of 4 points. Now, the last house, which a lot of people aren't aware of, is the insurance house, life insurance specifically. Your money is liquid, meaning you can get access to it anytime you want. It's safe. You get an average rate of return of maybe anywhere between 4 to 8%, depending on how it's structured. And you get amazing tax breaks for not only housing your money in there, but for passing it on to the next generation. Pretty cool stuff, right? A lot of people didn't know this. Well, welcome to Life Insurance Awareness Month.
Debunking, dispelling, and proving money myths wrong is a whole lot easier when you load up your weapon with these two things: power of association and diligence. Who you hang with, who you talk with, and who you do life with, you become. My wife and I are committed to building friendships and relationships with people who get it. That when we're around these group of folks, we don't have to worry about drama, we don't have to worry about gossip, and we don't have to worry about games. Not only do we enjoy each other's company, but we make each other sharper, and we constantly challenge each other to get to the next level in our lives. Settling is not an option. Reducing down our dreams is not an option. Question, are you hanging around with people like that? Because you see, performers hang with performers. Non-performers hang with other non-performers. Performers are always looking to improve their game. Non-performers are looking for a pity party. Performers compete, they take personal responsibility, and aware they don't know everything. Non-performers complain, blame, and hide the shame. Performers feel that the best of their life is right in front of them. Non-performers feel that the best of their life is behind them. And you've got to understand this about our human nature. It's always seeking to create instant gratification. And because of that, it also instantly creates myths. But when you combine the power of association and diligence, you will also instantly start dispelling a lot of other money myths because you are looking well into those matters. Now, how would you like to do that for the rest of your life? In the book, Richest Man Who Ever Lived, written by Stephen K. Scott, he says, diligence is a learnable skill that combines creative persistence, a smart working effort, rightly planned and rightly performed in a timely, efficient, and effective manner to attain a result that is pure and of the highest quality of excellence. And as you're watching this video, I'm wishing upon you a life of financial excellence. All right, well, that wraps up this episode. If you're watching this on YouTube, please participate on the YouTube Best Comments Challenge, where we're giving you this book, Living a Life of Significance by George Jordan, and an opportunity to meet my mentor here in Chicago, September 26th through the 28th in Chicago at the Insurance NewsNet Super Conference. Meanwhile, if you're watching this on YouTube and you haven't subscribed to our YouTube channel yet, I hope I earned a new subscriber. So please click subscribe right here and you click notifications to be alerted when we upload our next episode. And if you're watching this on Facebook and you have not liked our business page yet, please click like and follow our business page. Here's to you dispelling money myths for the rest of your life. Until we meet again, continue to live smart, continue to love smart, and be money smart today.